First thing, can you start something about yourself?
Yep. I am already 23 years in the company of Zeiss. I'm an optometrist. I am born in Belgium. I still live there, but I am traveling across the world as a VP of sales development. And we have allocated several countries to my group of countries, going from very old and mature markets like Belgium and the Netherlands and the Nordics into also very developing countries, where India is for sure one of them. This together with Middle East, North Africa, Eastern Europe. So it's a nice collection, geographically largely spread, but all in one focus. We can develop sales with Zeiss into these areas. So happy to be here.
Happy to have you.
Thanks.
I'll start with the first question that we have on this.
Yep.
Optical trade has come a long way in the last decade. What, according to you, can be counted as three major changes that have paved way for the brighter future of the industry as a whole?
Yep.
So among the three key factors.
The three key factors. For us, at least for me in a personal way, but also shared with the group as such, is that independent opticians, they are more and more aware that their differentiation, what they can bring to their consumers, is the lens story. So the eyeglass lens story. We all know that in the past it was frames that was a very dominant item within their trade. It's about fashion, it's about brands, it's about a style what they can create in their own local area. But as the markets get more and more global, read e-commerce is saying hello, this frame story is still important, but it's no longer so dominating the story. And they seek for something where they can differentiate themselves with. And it starts with refraction, creating their own lenses, their own prescriptions, and translating this into a perfect lens story for their end consumer. This is a trend what we see across the world, and which is for us as lens manufacturer, of course, heaven. Because as we, and that's the second change and the positive side of it, as we invented freeform, backside progressive freeform lenses, we really are in the cockpit of how to customize lenses. And this is what opticians also grant us and say, yeah, if there is a party where we can have this differentiation factor in and this customization factor in, we need to do Zeiss. So it's clear the penetration of customized lenses is in our product portfolio one of the highest. Other companies have followed us. They follow the same philosophy, but they do not yet have the same product mix as what we have, meaning we have a very big portion in individualized lenses. So that's a second one. So seeking for differentiation. Technology is driving novelties. And a last one is what I also already said. There is a big new dynamic in the market of who are the people who are the actors in this market. It was always ECPs. Then 30, 40 years ago, the first capital chains came in. And now there is another animal in, and that's e-commerce. So the trend will be, some people call it the hybrid trade. You must have a physical store, a brick and mortar store. But if you do not have something, or you don't have a digital presence, and I don't mean immediately a web shop, but if your LinkedIn presence, if your Facebook presence, if your Instagram presence is not in sync with what you are in your brick and mortar store, it's going to be difficult. So I think it's good to have this new incoming e-commerce people there to make us as independent or as capital chain people vivant and say, we are longer in this market, we can do here something. Okay? So these are three, for me at least, topics.
And you think, any idea how the online will go forward for lenses? Lenses is more of the experience. You have size experience stores where you come, get the refraction, and all of those.
It will only grow. So optics is not different from any other consumer product. There are a group of people who are seeking for convenience, who just want to stay at home, don't want to hit the traffic, want to, after days of work, sit down in their sofa and buy a pair of lenses. That's, we can love it or hate it, but that's a fact. People love convenience shopping. So we will get a fair share of this in our market as well. I don't believe it will kill the full brick and mortar stuff. It will, for me at least, not be 50-50, but there will be a much bigger share of what it is today. In how many years? In the next 5 years, the big quantum leap will be made by e-commerce. Okay.
You have a 2-decade-old association that size. You've been there for over 20 years now.
Here in India.
In India?
You mean, yeah, correct.
I'm talking about your personal association with Zayas has been.
Yeah, 23 years.
In India. Yeah. Okay. The key milestones that the brand has achieved over the years, 20 years, what would you say are the key milestones? Not just from the global perspective, mm-hmm. the technology perspective, but even in terms of your achievements, in terms of you started the store, the specialty stores, or what do you call those? Mm-hmm. Those kind of things. What would you say are the
key items? So the key items is more focusing on the technology innovations and not simply on, yes, we are here with the full portfolio and we have lenses which we can deliver, stock lenses in 24 hours. So the more hygienic stuff, you know, that's everybody needs to do this if you want to be successful in the market. Where we have focused upon is, first, how can we help our opticians so that they can be a different optician compared to their competitors? What is our offering into their game? Using more the brand, which is the only brand that an end consumer understands about lenses worldwide and also in India. So the brand recognition is something we need to make use of more. And to really help opticians, but also end consumers, towards an other optical level. So, where the times where people are only looking for a nice frame are definitely over. They are more and more aware, end consumer I mean, that it's with lenses they create vision, and not only with the frame. So, we need to show, via the opticians, that we are a partner who can deliver that differentiation, that other vision.
And in this objective, are there any key factors that we can say, okay, this is where we achieved this target, this is where we achieved this? Any particular instances? Tushar just took me through the milestones of where you had your first microscope, first air coated. In India, any particular things that you could say?
Well, 20 years ago, we started really in India. At that time, freeform was the big hype. So when what we really saw is that larger opticians already saw that benefit for their own concept. So they tapped into the individualized lens story, and it went over with progressive lenses, then even with single vision lenses, then with intermediate reading lenses, and it ends up after 18 years now having always an individual version of a standard product. So that is key to us. We will not only bring customization on the more enhanced lenses, also on a single vision lens, you can create your own lens. And this creation of lenses, if opticians have that in their mindset, that's their milestone. We started with progressives, and every second year there is a customized lens over there. Not to forget that, yes, we are 20 years here, but 10 years ago, we started with eyescription lenses. That is like the top notch of individualization what you can have, because we detect high order aberrations of a human eye. This, together with a subjective refraction of an optician, is sent to our calculation lab in Germany. There the order is given to the Indian labs how to produce the lens for this specific right or left lens from an end consumer. And at present, if you call really a milestone, well, that's a real milestone.
Yep.
Okay.
That was also realistic.
Yeah.
You explained the
thing. And by the way, this is a lens that is not able to be sold over e-commerce. So if you would call it a milestone as well, what our company is doing is, yes, to have randomly lenses being produced, clickable, But on the other side, there is a brick and mortar collection available for people who say, yes, this is over the counter, but here, let's look into your eyes. And I think commercially, that is then a real milestone. Technically, that's a clear promise to our customers. Every second year, ZEISS needs to bring a novelty into the industry. And if you want, we can share as from the years 2000, which every 2 years was a novelty what we have launched, which, by the way, has been copied by all the other ones. Freeform, individualization, copied. Coatings who are invisible, starting to be copied after many years later, but anyway, they are doing it. Digital lenses, copied. Eyescription lenses, still not yet copied, but people try to do something with this story, try to adapt it as well. So I think for us, that is the main differentiator. We give a promise to our customers of always leading the technology. That is inherent to a company where we belong to. ZEISS is a technology leader. And it's not only in the lens business. We lead in R&D, but that's also in the other divisions. And we benefit from this philosophy. Okay. And that's our only differentiator.
Technology and innovation.
Yeah, absolutely.
When you say innovation, so some light on the research and development initiatives that ZEISS undertakes to live up to the standards of living produced. So actually you answered the whole thing.
Yep.
So, eyescription.
Freeform, eyescription, digital lenses, making sure that in all our lenses, our digital lifestyle is incorporated. So 4 years ago already, we have lenses made, progressive lenses, where the new reading needs of an end consumer, iPad, iPhone, they keep it 20% closer to their nose. Their convergence is higher than before, shorter than before. So we interpretate our lens designs of this new digital lifestyle. So we follow what end consumers really need. DriveSafe, another one. Why in the hell did we bring DriveSafe lenses on the market? Not because a couple of German people said, hey, we are the country where the most cars are maybe invented. It's because end consumer said, it's all great lenses and so on, but while driving, I feel sometimes a blur, or I am not sure while driving at night. So we listen to these end consumers. We do trial lenses with a lot of end consumers and come up with a solution for them, which they can use every day, but especially in their car. Okay?
The most important criteria that are prioritized by the team while developing any new product, irrespective of the market.
First, listening to the end consumer. That's really the basis of everything. We don't produce anything anymore that is like, oh, what a nice dream I have here in Germany. End consumers are the only indicators, that's one. Secondly, it must improve significantly from the situation what we have today. So if we couldn't achieve with a DriveSafe lens an improvement in the night vision, then sorry, but ZEISS would not bring that product. And it should be relevant into the global market. So making a lens for only one single area, that time is over. It's a global world, should be a global product. So these are, for me at least, the three criteria.
How have these products been received by the market?
Well,
in different
markets. It is so unbelievable, but the optical trade is the same across the whole world. That means that innovations or novelties take always time before people really see the benefit of it. And I mean the trade sees the benefit. End consumers, when I would go to an end consumer here in the street and say, did you know that ZEISS will bring clear lenses with 100% UV protection, I'm sure that Indian people say, yeah, well, I want these. Why wouldn't I not be protecting my eyes against UV? With sun cream, I cannot go over my eyes, so that's the only area on the face or on the body that is unprotected. But an optician is sometimes waiting a bit. And not sometimes. Globally, people are a little bit reluctant. Let's give you the example of DriveSafe, launched in 2015. It took till 2016 before people say, God damn it, you have a jewel in your hands there. This is amazing. People are absolutely reflecting. It's better for night vision. I see relaxed with these lenses, da 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 da. So why did we give 6 months, 8 months time before the end consumer could already benefit from this? So that would be one of my jobs, to really say, stop having this awaiting position. Listen to the story, make up your mind and execute. And don't wait, because e-commerce is speeding up a lot to the communication to the end consumers. Imagine an e-commerce site is doing immediately a DriveSafe lens, and consumers are immediately getting the communication and can act. So opticians need to be faster in implementing innovations. That's a very, very clear message.
And the other products, DriveSafe is one. And the other products, how would they be? And
yes. So, for instance,
you see, there are no differences between the India, Middle East, Southeast Asia.
It's all the same.
Overall, it's the
same. You know, look at digital lenses. Digital lenses is a lens for young people. In their ages of 30, 32 years old, they start to feel that with their digital lifestyle, they fall a bit short in their good vision. Because, again, they use that their iPhones and iPads at a closer distance. So their accommodation and their convergence is under stress. We call it digital eye strain. So they are seeking for a solution for this. Well, that is so beautiful to see, that if an optician is saying, you can have a choice now, here is a single vision lens or a digital one, that very quickly end consumers, not all of them, not 100 on 100, but for sure a majority of them say, hey, that's something for me, I want to have this. By the way, that's also a lens that is not clickable, meaning you cannot order this online. An optician needs to do a refraction act in order to be able to order these lenses. So he shows himself to the market as being the more professional. And it's with all the other inventions we did in the last 10 years, people need to jump quicker, find a clear, good selling story to the end consumer, and then make the best out of it.
And what are the initiatives that you've taken to get the optician aware of these things, how to get him the information and all of those aspects?
Very good question. Yeah.
He needs to know it first.
Yeah. Very good question, and there we needed to improve. We, as technical and innovative driven company, we only had a technical story to our opticians. We baggered them down with optometry schemes and with big slides and technical stories. And we always forgot to, how do we translate this now to an end consumer that is not interested into all these technical flavors. And this has changed a good 10 years ago, where whenever a new product is in, yes, the technology needs to be explained, and we do it hardcore via e-academy trainings, via face-to-face trainings, but always, if there is always an extra block in that, on that seminar, with how to sell it out now. And the feedback of our opticians is, there you really help us, dear size. It's good to get your technical flavor, and we love it for our own, but the fact that you invest in time of how to sell out, that is the best gift you can give us.
How do you do this? I mean, yes, you do this, but yeah. In what, the geographies are different. India is known to be a country where reaching or communicating out, reaching out to the end optician is quite a challenge.
Yeah.
A place like Singapore, yes.
Yeah.
60 kilometers can be done.
Yeah.
Possible, even though it has its
challenges. Very, very big group of salespeople. So compared to other markets, there is a difference in India. We really have here an army of passionate salespeople going out, visiting door by door. That's step one. Step two is gathering these people for local seminars, whether it's a breakfast session or an evening event, and so on. E-Academy, very important factor that we open up a learning on the internet, where people can get scorings per module that they achieve. And then we have here a group of trainers, specifically outside of the sales, but specifically there and invested for to train opticians and their selling people or their optometrists what they have. So for us, education and investment in training is a very big marketing spend.
Coming to Zeiss as a company, mm-hmm. known to be a company that does a lot of CSR initiatives, anything that you would like to talk about where the CSR initiatives have actually made every CSR initiative makes a difference,
yeah.
but something particular that you would like to speak about which has made a direct impact or a strong impact from Zeiss perspective?
Yeah. Then I go back to, it's maybe a standard product when we speak about finished single vision lenses. That is like mentioned as a commodity lens, like where can't you find a stock lens? And we have pushed it to a higher level while mentioning that if you buy a Zeiss lens, a stock lens, you buy in fact 5 extra benefits compared to any other stock lens in the world. And these 5 ones were a talk towards the opticians, but they very quickly brought it over to their end consumers. And consumers who are in the need to say, why should I buy a Zeiss one and why can't I click another one? And it is, you are sure it is made by our own hands because the Z logo is burned into the lens. It is still the most clear lens available. Colts testing, if you want we can share even those data. Colts has tested our lenses compared to any other lens manufacturer in the world. And we are 50% less reflecting, also on our stock lenses, thanks to our clear coatings. It is a ophthalmic based lens, meaning we will first go over to the ophthalmic quality instead of the pure aesthetic quality. So our base curve story is a unique one to Zeiss. And last but not least, we have a patent on our anti-static coating that is not able to be removed while wearing the lens, while it is not put on the top layers of the coating, it is in the lower layers of the coating. But now there is a fifth one, and it is that these stock lenses are 100% UV protecting in all indexes what you can buy. So coming back to your question, where did we see an immediate effect of people saying, gosh, this is an absolutely differentiator? It's stock lenses. So we have innovative high-end lenses, but one that opticians really picked up, stock lenses, Zeiss stock lenses.
So yeah. I think Boris's question was more around CSR or corporate social responsibility, as you know, as a group, what do we do? So I think globally, yes, we have a lot of things that we do, but I think specific to India, and specific to our business.
I believe the prime thing about Zeiss, it's not driven for profit.
Yeah.
Yes.
So we are known to be a company which is doing things
right?
Trust, right?
Yeah.
So the whole idea is to create something, do something which benefits
society.
Through technology, benefits
yeah.
the society.
I think Wilson will go deeper into that question as
yes.
he's the more the head of all the divisions within India, and he and all of us have a very clear focus on this.
More about the trust aspect. I mean, how does Zeiss differentiate from the rest of the companies? To me, the whole idea about the fundamentals of a company
mm-hmm.
to be so different is a unique thing. I mean, it's not like you
yeah.
are another just for profit company.
Yeah, so when we look at all the revenues what we do within Zeiss, there is every year around about 10% within the vision care that is immediately flushed towards R&D or T&I, however we call it, in order to make sure we make products not only for the unique or for the happy few in the world, but it's always one term. It's a product that must match for everybody. And when we said, yeah, are there differences? Yes, there are differences in product mixes. India is a developing market, so the penetration of progressive lenses is still lesser than in other areas. But all the lenses, when a treatment is good on a progressive lens, that same treatment goes on to stock lenses. So that basic idea is always inherent to it.
Okay, I think this is the second last question. In the last 1 year, times are changing fast. Earlier, what used to happen in 5 years now happens in 2 years, three years. 1 year is quite a significant time now. If you have to take the last 1 year, in which market, if you have to say the differences that have happened in India, specifically in India, Middle East, and Southeast Asia, how are things changing in these three regions individually?
Very clearly, and I will repeat myself, e-commerce is knocking on the door. India, it's already happened. In other areas, because of legal restrictions, they do not get the full power. Look at Turkey, for instance. There you may not sell optical goods over e-commerce, so there you don't have it that much. But nevertheless, e-commerce is knocking on the door. That's one. And as a consequence, opticians start to be aware that they need to act differently. And you see it at the number of Zeiss Vision stores that is opening across the world. You see at the penetration of our investment goods, refraction machines, measuring machines, pre-screening machines, that is really getting a vast business for us and also for our competitors. So that is a big change. Opticians are starting to invest in making their next 10 years, their next 20 years ready. And that can only happen while investing in the story of refraction and eyeglasses.
If you have to compare the global market with and with specific, I mean the global growth compared to growth in the European countries, Middle East, Southeast Asia, and India.
Yeah.
How would these compare to each other?
So people in Europe will not maybe love what I will say, but we call them the old mature markets. There the growth is with the economical growth, you can expect the growth within your own retail goods. So the 3 to 4% growth is now there in Europe. When you compare it into the developing markets, and India is the, for us, the fastest growing area, then it's not only double digits, it's meaning the very positive double digits. The above 20% growths are simply here for us. And this is not in the last year, but also the years that came before. Middle East is very driven on the oil topic. So when the oil prices are not very positive, well, then the whole trade, the whole, how do you call that, consumer goods sales, retail is also under pressure. But still, what is very good at all these markets is that there is a product mix change. Going from the very standard lenses, the over-the-shelf, the stock lenses, people start to create lenses, start to RX them, start to let them produce. And that's why the growth is in all these areas now very positive. There is a shift from the standard to the better lens. And we benefit from it, and also the optician, but for sure also the end consumer. He simply gets a lens for his eyes and not something that was on the stock.
What about Southeast Asia?
Southeast Asia is, I wouldn't call it like old Europe, but they have already a higher penetration in progressive lenses. I'm speaking about Singapore, I'm speaking about Malaysia. In other areas like Vietnam and so on, this is then more in towards India, large single vision market. But Singapore, for sure, that's a progressive market all the way. Yeah. Okay?
I think you covered most of the things.
Good.
Anything else that you would want to add as a message to our readers?
Yes, it is that people need to be aware that they need to choose in the next months to come, in the next years to come, on who will be their partner for their lens supplies. And I keep this very general and open and neutral, but people need to sit down and say, where will I be with my business in the next 3 years or in the next 5 years? And then look for who is the lens provider who is able to help me in making this dream, this concept, doable. Is it going to be Zeiss? Well, count on this one.
Sounds very nice, and unfortunately, sadly, I told you it was the last question, but opens up this thing.